I'm joined now by Dr. Vincent Lin. Thank you for joining us. I would like to know more about the link between dementia and deafness. This is one of your specialties. It's going to be discussed at CI 2016. So what's the latest?
The latest is that we know that if you're a person with hearing loss, your risk of developing dementia and the rate of progression is much faster than someone who doesn't. And this gives us a potential opportunity to intervene. And the question that still hasn't been answered is, if someone with hearing loss is treated with a device like a cochlear implant or a hearing aid, can this potentially slow down or even impede the progression of dementia? And that's a very exciting proposition because dementia is a huge problem worldwide.
Absolutely. How can family members sort of watch out for this and ask the right questions?
Well, I think, you know, if you have a member in your family who has hearing loss, they'll show some very characteristic signs. They will socially withdraw. They often will have a lot of difficulty hearing, especially in challenging environments, so like family dinners when there's a lot of background noise, environments where there'll be a lot of kind of challenging, kind of competing noises, they often would not either withdraw or not want to attend.
Absolutely. And with the aging population, of course, hearing loss is going to be more and more prevalent, potentially. Now, how about the stigma around hearing loss? How do you deal with that? How do you approach that?
Well, I think patients have to understand that, you know, it's such a common problem these days. And in the past, it was always associated with people who are older. And so people talk about my grandparents' hearing aids. But the truth is hearing loss is something that affects people of all ages, from babies to people who are, you know, young to middle-aged to old. And I think once people realize that it's a common problem, then I think that takes a little bit of the stigma away. But as a hearing professional, I think we have to encourage our patients to understand that the devices now these days are quite powerful, often quite discreet, and are very, very effective and help them hear better.
Where is the research headed for older adults and CI?
Well, I think that the question that remains to be answered is if patients with hearing loss are treated, either with a CI or a potential hearing aid, does this affect the course of dementia progression? And there's a lot of research that's still kind of answering this question, but it will take time. It's a very long process, and I think it will take a number of years for this to be answered fully.
What are you personally looking forward to at CI 2016?
Well, besides catching up with a lot of colleagues and good friends, the research kind of going on with dementia and hearing loss progresses a lot every year. Just seeing what the new links and new possibilities in terms of ways that we can intervene today with our patients will be very, very exciting to hear about.
Dr. Vincent Lin, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Best of luck with everything.
Thank you very much.